What's going on, guys? Josh here from Momentum Productions, and today we're taking a look at the Juintech Crane 3 Lab gimbal. Now, this gimbal is not yet available to the public. It's still in its prototype slash beta stage, so I can still show you how it stabilizes your footage, and I can show you the servos and how some of the functionality works. So let's take a closer look. Over the weekend, I was able to go to the LA Auto Show, and I was able to take my Crane 3 Lab along for the ride, and I was able to get some pretty awesome shots. Similar to the Weeble Lab gimbal, we're gonna have vortex mode, and what this allows us to do is capture 360 degree roll shots. So you get continuous rotation of the roll axis, so you can get some pretty unique shots like this one here. Also, we get POV, so if you want to limit your roll angle shots to 45 degrees on both the left and right side, that's also available to you too. You can access these shooting modes by pressing the buttons that are located on the handle. Now, when we take a quick look on the handle here, you notice that it looks funky. It's similar to the Weeble Lab, but it obviously is a much larger gimbal. So instead of having a tripod that can go from the bottom of the gimbal to the top, like on the Weeble Lab, it already has a fixed handle, so you can do low angle shots really easily without having to go into inverted mode. And I know some of you have been complaining about going into inverted mode, not just on the Juintech Crane series gimbals, but on other gimbals like the Ronin S. Inverted mode is tricky to get into, but now with this fixed handle, we can easily just go like this and we're automatically in inverted mode. Within this handle, we also have three 18650 batteries, which is rated to give us between 16 to 18 hours of battery life if your camera is properly balanced. And it also depends on your payload. So if you have a cage and other accessories, that's also going to affect the battery life. Now, the battery life will decrease with more accessories that you put on this gimbal. For example, as you notice, I have two servos on here, one controlling the zoom, one controlling the focus, and that all is powered via the 18650 batteries. So as soon as you add those on, the battery life will go down. You can also power your camera directly off of the gimbal. That again is going to decrease battery life. Now with this gimbal, we also get an HD video transmission system. This is still not properly developed and they're working on it, which is why it's still in the prototype stages. But just note that it does have this feature, and once it's perfected, it'll be able to connect to the ZY Play app on your phone, and you'll be able to monitor HD footage via your camera's feed. On the transmission box, we also get a DC 8-volt current output, which means that you can power things like an external monitor. So you don't even need to have your monitor with a bulky battery attached to it. You can just use the monitor itself and connect it directly to your gimbal and power it via those 18650 batteries. But don't forget, you are decreasing your battery life. So if you're gonna be having all these accessories attached to your gimbal, it would be smart if you buy an extra set of batteries. Now, when we're talking about these dual servo systems, we have the zoom and the focus all controlled via the gimbal. On the handle, we have the zoom rocker, which will obviously control your zoom in and zoom outs. And we have a follow focus dial here on the lower handle. Now, don't forget, when you get this gimbal, depending on the package that you get, these two servos are different sizes because they produce different torque outputs. So the zoom servo is gonna be slightly larger than the follow focus servo. Similar to the Crane 2, we have our LED indicator screen, so you can change things like aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. We also can change the gimbal's parameters such as motor power and calibration. You can also see all of your current shooting modes, such as pan follow, full follow, lock mode, POV, and vortex mode. And of course, we get real-time data of your battery life. On the left side of the gimbal, we have two rosette mounts, so you can attach accessories like your external monitor, your phone for monitoring the HD video from the transmission box, or lights, microphones, whatever you want, basically. Right under the fixed handle, we also have a joystick, which allows you to manually position the gimbal in any angle. When it comes down to balancing this gimbal, it is trickier since it is a larger frame, and because of these dual servos, it does take more time to set up your camera properly. But because of these new axis locks, you can balance each individual axis one at a time, which makes balancing a lot easier. Also, for when you're transporting the gimbal, you want to be able to lock up each motor. That way, it doesn't bang around while you travel. The payload of this gimbal is 4.5 kilos, so you can mount things like the Ursa Mini Pro, C200, C300, FS5. A lot of cinema-grade cameras are able to balance on this gimbal. Now, recently, I've been posting a lot of BTS videos on my Instagram with this gimbal, and people have been saying that it looks very awkward to hold, but believe it or not, I think it's a new unique way of holding a gimbal, and I was at the LA Auto Show holding this thing for 3 hours straight and I did not feel tired. And whenever I wasn't shooting, I was holding this gimbal like a briefcase and walking around. So it really works out pretty well. And this gimbal is also well balanced, so when you do hold it like a briefcase, it's not gonna feel too front heavy or back heavy. The roll motor has also been dropped so you can see full coverage of your camera's viewfinder. Overall, I am pretty happy with this gimbal and I can't wait to see what happens when the full production version is ready. And there is gonna be a lot of firmware updates, so stay tuned for that. If you do want to pre-order this gimbal, I'll leave a B&H link for you guys in the video description box below, so make sure you check that out. And let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel with notifications on. I'll see you next time. Peace!